us a lot, but he didn't know, he didn't sign up, so he's one waiting if there's an open spot.
Okay.
Well, you're that way.
So for, there's an extra little announcement right before communion. So right after Father receives the chalice, be up there and ready. Once he partakes, then there's a whole page of announcement about how communion works. And if you can show examples, I put that on there, like about extending your arms out to receive communion. If you can extend, crossing your arms over your chest if you can't receive.
After the prayer.
Yeah,
drink the chalice, then I go
out
and take that.
Yeah, but just be ready to start once he has taken the chalice.
Melissa, I have
something. Oh, thank you. Merry Christmas. Okay.
Hear my voice? I was playing with your voice a little bit.
Yeah, we're in the ballpark
yard. Cindy.
Okay, in 14.
Can you take over here? And Cindy, I need to talk to you.
That's not
a joke.
Cindy, if you can come here and let's have that Eucharist. Okay. So, what are you?
Double duty.
Cindy, let's have you over here on the side. So you're going to assist the Father. You'll be at the end of the queue helping him. When he moves to this section, you move with him. Okay? So for the far section, for the choir section, so he stands in his normal spot, you stand at the end of the pew, and this will be a second communion minister.
So they can choose to go to him or her.
Be on the right, and I'll be on the left.
Okay, be in the center, and then you can sit at the end of the if the pew's here. You stand right here. Yes, but at the farther end, so they have room to walk and get away. At the end of the aisle. So if the pew starts right here, where your Father, it ends here. You stand here and go. Okay. Yeah, you help him, and then you move to this section and help him with that.
You have a helper. Yes.
Keith, you help the deacon with the center section, then you be the main one for the next section over. And then you be St. Joseph, and then you be the helper for that section.
Perfect. Okay. All right.
Make sure to sanitize your hands before you get the ciborium. Make sure you sanitize your hands.
Yes.
The lector will be up there doing an announcement about how communion works, so it may be a little tricky getting to the sanitizer, but there's several of them up there.
Okay, my question is, is there any right or wrong way to walk up there? You just get to where you need to be? I would just
all three of you stay on this side. It's easier to give it to you all, and then go. Yep.
Okay, perfect.
Yep.
All right.
Okay.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, and Merry Christmas. Today we celebrate the Nativity of the Lord. Please take home a bulletin today or visit the parish website or Facebook page for information on upcoming events and important guidelines for attending Mass. The mission of Catholic Charities is to serve our neighbors of all faiths through help, hope, and hospitality. Thank you for being a part of this mission and for your gifts to the Christmas collection. Offerings can be left in the black baskets at the entrance to the church as you leave. Masks are required while you're in church and must be properly fitted over both your nose and mouth and are worn throughout Mass. Our intention for this Mass is Paul Lark. Our presider is Father Greg Hamas. Please stand.
The Lord is come, let earth receive the King. Let every heart prepare Him now, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and earth and heaven and nature sing.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
With your spirit.
So welcome to all, and a very Merry Christmas to you all. It's the first time I've done a 2 o'clock a Christmas Eve Mass, but it's that kind of year. So I welcome you all, a special welcome to any visitors, and a special welcome to all watching the live stream at home. Let us all connect to Jesus. He came to be with us, to be born in our world. He is near. No matter if you're here or at home, the Lord is near. He's come to be with us. We celebrate his birth. So brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins. And so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you praise for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand, the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us, for you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who have made this most sacred night radiant with the splendor of the true light, grant, we pray, that we who have known the mysteries of his light on earth may also delight in his gladness in heaven, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you as at the harvest, as people make merry when dividing spoils. For the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaster, you have smashed as on the day of Midian. For every boot that tramped in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us. Upon his shoulder dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Forever Father, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful, from David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confirms and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Is born a Savior, Christ the Lord. Sing to the Lord a new song, sing to the Lord all your lands. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Announce his salvation day after day. Tell his glory among the nations, among all peoples, his wondrous deeds. Let the heavens be glad and the earth rejoice. Let the sea and what fills it resound. Let the plains be joyful and all that is in them. Then shall all the trees of the forest exult. They shall exult before the Lord, for he comes. For he comes to rule the earth. He shall rule the world with justice, and the peoples with his constancy. Today is born a Savior, Christ the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to Titus. Beloved, the grace of God has appeared, saving all and training us to reject godless ways and worldly desires, and to live temperately, justly, and devoutly in this age, as we await the blessed hope, the appearance of the glory of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us to deliver us from all lawlessness and to cleanse for himself a people as his own, eager to do what is good. The word of the Lord.
With you.
With your
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria. So all went to be enrolled, each to his own town. And Joseph too went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David that is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were shepherds in that region living in the fields and keeping the night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today in the city of David a Savior has been born for you, who is Christ and Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." The Gospel of the Lord. Again, Merry Christmas to all. Well, I have some good news and some bad news. It's been that kind of year. But the difference between the good news and the bad news is it's not very much. It's only a preposition that changes bad news to good news. And let me explain it. There's two phrases I want to talk about here. And these phrases are very different. First phrase is "of all people." The second phrase is "for all people." It might not sound very different to you. Of all people, for all people. Only difference, of or for, a preposition. Well, let me show the difference in the 2 years and then try to explain what the heck I'm talking about. 2020 has been quite a year, you know that. But I'd say it's been a year of all people. And the year I'm going to contrast 2020 with is the year zero. Yeah, don't email me later and say there's no year zero. I know that. There actually isn't. There's a 1 BC and a 1 AD. And scholars say Jesus probably was born, maybe the ones I like say 2 or 3 BC. But anyways, we'll go with zero because whenever Jesus was born, I say that year is a year for all people. 2020, year of all people, year zero for all people. Okay, here's where it makes more sense. I love my words, sorry. It's geeky today. But the Bible is written in, the New Testament's written in Greek. Do you know the Greek word for of all people? The Greek word is pandemic. Yucky word. We don't like it. Of all people. That's why I said 2020 is the year of all people. I'm not talking politics. It's the year of a pandemic has really defined it. Pan means all. Demos is people. Of all people. Why do they call it a pandemic? Well, it affects all people. Isn't everybody been affected this year? Of all people. Well, let's contrast that with the year zero. And we heard my other form, for all people, in our gospel. Pandemic bad news, we need some good news. Well, guess what? The angel said this, said to the shepherds, do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Almost the same words there. Almost identical, just the synonym for people, but of or for makes a big difference. Angel doesn't say pandemic, but it says good news for all people. Well, we know what the good news is. It's the birth of our Savior. So such a little difference of verses 4, but what a big difference it makes. So I want to expand on this in another thing. I assume everybody here is probably a believer. That's why you came out tonight. But you might not be, or I don't know. Sometimes people get drug along here. But do you know the difference between an atheist and a believer? It's a preposition. Same sort of thing. I think the only difference is of versus for. So think about it. I would challenge, I would say atheists actually do believe in God. Again, I got to explain myself. I know you think I'm crazy. If you really pinned an atheist down, I think they'd say they do believe in a God of the people, of us. What does that mean? Well, they probably mean this, that God is of us, that we made him up. We invented him. We created him. So he's of us. And a lot of the philosophers that we don't like too much, like Karl Marx and Friedrich Nietzsche, they said that, yeah, God is a projection of us. We just take parts of ourselves and we throw it up there and we say, that's God. God of us. Big difference is a God for us. Big difference. But that's what believers believe. A God for us. That God, he is different than us. He's not made up. And that God is on our side. He loves us. Advent, we all like to sing, O come, Emmanuel, right? What does Emmanuel mean? God with us. He's so for us, he is with us. Tonight, we heard the Christmas gospel. The newborn son is named Jesus. And what does Jesus mean? God saves. I think if I had to paraphrase that, if God's saving us, he's for us, right? He's not against us. God for us. That's what we believe. And what a difference just that preposition makes, of versus for. God of us, or God for us. It's the difference between a pandemic and a savior, the good news and the bad news, an atheist and a believer. So, how would we apply this today? What could we take home with us? Well, I think there's a message of faith, hope, and love tonight. First, we start with faith. Reminded what our faith is about. God is for us. That's what we believe. A God who loves us. Absolutely. And that there is something for us. I think why people don't believe is they don't believe there is something in this universe for us. There's no for in the universe, no purpose. It's random. It just comes together by chance. And we are the products of that. We are of it. And even something like love, to those who would not believe, it's just a random chance. Maybe it's a evolutionary survival instinct. It's all about surviving. There's no for. What's it all for? But we believe, faith, that it's all for something. That there is something out there that is for something. It made the world for a reason. Made us for a reason. God is for us. So for those who might struggle with faith, I think we need to encounter that God. The God for us. What do we call that? I think we call that love. And when we encounter a love beyond this world, it's possible. We realize there really is a God for us. So faith is a lesson tonight. I think hope is a big one we need, especially in 2020. Hope. What do we believe in hope? That we are made for something. Made for heaven. That's what we're made for. There's a purpose to life. Even though we endure some troubled times and pandemics, we remember we're not made for this earth. This is not our home forever. But we're made for heaven. That gives us hope to endure. But love, I think tonight especially is about love, that love of God. And the take-home lesson, again, the preposition for, if you could just remember for, we have something to live for. Something to live for. And it's for love. To be loved by God. To love others. That's the meaning, the purpose. It's all for something. That's a lot and a preposition. For versus of. It amazed me to think about it, that the word difference between pandemic and the good news for all the people, just so very little, but it makes all the difference. So I'm going to rephrase that. 2020 is not a year of the people. We shouldn't define it the year of the pandemic, because the year 2020 really isn't any different than the year zero. Because God still is for us. And the good news is still for us today. And that makes all the difference. The angel said to the shepherds, "Do not be afraid. For behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all people. For today in the city of David, a Savior has been born for you, who is Messiah and Lord. So come, let us adore him." Amen. So let us stand. We believe in a God who is for us, so let us profess our faith tonight at the words the Holy Spirit was, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate the Virgin Mary, we actually genuflect because Jesus takes flesh. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. We do believe God is for us. He sent us the greatest gift of all, his Son. So we lift up our prayers to him this night.
For the church, that we may give witness to the angel's message of great joy that God comes to save us and bring peace to our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in the world, that the Prince of Peace will turn hearts from violence and open every heart to the dignity of all human life, from conception until natural death, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in the hospital, the homeless, and the imprisoned, that the coming of Christ may bring hope and healing for them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are traveling or away from home this day, especially members of the military, that God will guide their movements, preserve them in love, and bring them safely home, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, that they may encounter the peace of God in his everlasting kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, we give thanks that you have given us the gift of Jesus, our Savior. Help us to live faith, hope, and love, to live for him, to live for love. Hear our prayers. We ask them all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the sky looked down where he lay, the little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. The cattle are lowing, the baby awakes, but little Lord Jesus no crying he makes. I love thee, Lord Jesus, look down from the sky and stay by my cradle till morning is nigh.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, good and the good of all his holy church.
May the oblation of this day's feast be pleasing to you, O Lord, we pray. that through this most holy exchange we may be found in the likeness of Christ, in whom our nature is united to you, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, On his constant intercession and your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Joseph, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
For communion, everyone will exit to their left when directed by the ushers. When you are ready to receive the Eucharist, please extend your arms out to the minister to maintain as much distance as possible. You will then return to your seat following the arrows on the floor going to your right. We will distribute to three sections first, beginning with the side by the choir area, the center aisle on the right of the section, on the right, and the section by St. Joseph. After those sections are done, the other two sections will receive. Ushers will direct you. Please be patient. Everyone must exit the pews for communion so that people don't have to walk over others. If you are not able to receive communion, cross your arms over your chest for a blessing. Communion will only be distributed on the hand during Mass. If you require communion on the tongue, you will be served after Mass is finished.
Town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee, Lord, among thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. For Christ is born of Mary and gathered all above. While mortals sleep, the angels keep their watch of wandering love. All morning stars together proclaim the holy birth, and praises sing to God the King and peace to all on earth. The Savior.
light, radiant beams from thy holy face, with the dawn of redeeming grace. Jesus, Lord, at thy birth, Jesus, Lord, at thy birth.
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, that we who are gladdened by participation in the feast of our Lord's, our Redeemer's Nativity, may through him an honorable way of life become worthy of union with him, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. It's been that kind of year. I don't know. It hasn't done that till right now. My microphone.
We wish you a very Merry Christmas. Just the only announcement, ushers will help dismiss so that we keep you distance. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth, mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Drive all the nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark the herald angels sing,